Okay, my name is Lutricia Ennis, but they call me Pat. I was born in Alabama, Birmingham, Alabama, a little small town they call Graysville. That's where I used to live. And my mother died when I was very, very young, and my father had left me there to live with my grandmother. I started school at the age of six. At that time, we didn't have pre-K or kindergarten. And we used to have to walk to school. And the school, I guess, was about 4 miles or maybe longer that we had to walk. We had no school buses at that time for kids, black kids. At that time, they called us Negroes. They didn't have school buses at that time. So anyway, we had to walk. So we used to take shortcuts to get to school. So we used to go down this hill, our shortcut, and go to school. Sometimes we went through the cemetery to get to the school. Our school went from first grade to, I believe, to the eighth grade. But the thing of it is, when we go down this hill, on this in the back of this hill on the side, white families lived there, and we used to call it the white camp. And even though I was 6 years old, we knew we were not supposed to go back there at all because it was very dangerous. And if we went back there, we knew that we would not come back alive. That was what we were told. But on the way home sometimes, we used to see the white people, and they would be on a truck, the kids would be in the back. And they would call us niggers. "Hey, nigger, you know, what you doing here?" And they used to throw rocks and sticks, whatever, at us. And we used to run. I mean, we were scared. And of course, we used to, kids, we used to call them soda crackers, you know, things like that. And we ran because we were afraid. And so that was the way it was. And I was 6 years old at that time. And then I remember a time when we had salesmen that came to the house. And I think he had to be maybe about 20 years old. I was a little kid, so he looked old to me, but he could have been younger or he could have been older. But you know, when he was selling insurance, life insurance, and he used to come by, and my grandmother used to give him money. And when he spoke to my grandmother, he would address her as Katie Mae. And then when she spoke to him, she had to call him Mister. And I could never understand why this young man would be calling my grandmother Katie Mae. That used to bother me a lot. But anyway, that was a lot what was going on at that time. And then there was a time that these people, white people, used to come through our town at night. It was always at night. And they would come on their trucks and they would be shooting their guns and, you know, waving sticks and throwing rocks and breaking windows in our house. There was one time my neighbor next door, they burned a cross in her yard. And you know, we would be hiding and we would be afraid. And my aunt told me this a little before I came here today. I remember my grandfather worked in the coal mine, and he worked next to whites. They worked next to each other. And he was a person that was very outspoken. So if he saw something that was done wrong, or you said something wrong to him or any other blacks, he would say something. They did not like that. So one night, she said, they came to our house and they burnt a cross in our yard. And they were calling him, "Nigger, nigger, come out, come out, come out, nigger." And then they were saying something about him working in the coal mine. And they said to him that he should keep his mouth shut. and not cause any problems where he was working. But that's the thing that mostly impressed me more, of how, you know, the Ku Klux Klan, and they were all dressed in white. I don't know if it was sheets or whatever it was, but they were all dressed in white, and they all had their face covered, so you didn't know who they were. But we didn't live close to the white neighborhood, but we had to go shopping in the white neighborhood. And we used to call them Mr. and Mrs. And they used to call my grandmother, grandfather by their first name.